Hi everyone, I'm Praveen, he's Jayanth. Welcome to In the Car 9. So, we need to do the first thing first. Mm-hmm. We have to announce our top three people from our last video.
Absolutely.
People who have guessed it right, they have to be in the car with us, right? So, We have selected the top three.
I think, first of all, thanks for an overwhelming response.
Yeah.
We got over 50 people trying to tell where we were. And I think that was really amazing to see such response. Thanks a lot.
Yeah, and absolutely.
Probably you have the names.
Yeah, so one is Brinda.
Okay.
She's the first one.
Okay.
So congratulations, Brinda. So you will be with us in the car. Mm-hmm. So that's the first person. And the second one is our dear friend Raghavendra Deshmukh.
Yeah.
So he's our second person who's going to be in the car with us.
Uh-huh.
And the third one
Is Avikshit Bhushan.
Yeah.
Avikshit Bhushan, congratulations. We'll probably have you folks in the car very shortly.
Absolutely.
So please choose your topics. We speak maximum for maybe 10 minutes to 15 minutes, not more than that. We don't do any edits, so better be prepared for a live discussion, because what you see is what you get.
Absolutely.
We don't do any kind of edits other than having our first B-roll of whatever we tried last time with a little bit of music and things like that, because we are not editing experts.
Sure.
So folks, be ready with your topics.
So your invitations are on the way. So
your invitations are on the way.
Congratulations and thanks for all the support you guys put across. So.
Yeah. And keep a watch out on the space of where we are, because there'll be a lot of interesting questions coming up. It's not just about where we are.
Yeah.
There'll be a lot of other things that will be coming up shortly.
Sure. Okay. Yeah. Super. So, we all are inspired a lot by the superhero capabilities, right, Jayanth?
Yes.
And, you know, from, mutating ourselves to converting into Spider-Mans to Iron-Mans of the world.
Yeah.
We have been, you know, inspired by these superheroes.
Yeah.
So, today's topic is about, you know, how do you become a, let's say, move your journey or move away from being disabled to becoming hyper-able.
Yeah.
To have superhuman capabilities.
Absolutely.
So this is already a great thing for me, because, you know, for us in the society, if somebody is disabled,
mm-hmm.
we feel they can't do much.
True.
That's the general sense, right?
Yes.
Because if somebody says, you know, I have lost my leg,
extend a hand of support. Or,
that's it. So we always feel, you know, pity about them, and we feel that they can't do things like what we do.
Absolutely.
And we tend to ignore them a lot.
Yeah.
Right, but the story is changed in this generation.
Yeah.
The people who are disabled are going to be hyper-abled.
Yes.
Which means they can be better than the normal people.
Absolutely.
So this is the topic for today.
And technology has helped a lot in...
Totally.
On how that is changing their lives completely.
Totally, totally. Yeah. So let's start with the simple concepts of, you know, prosthetics.
Yeah.
So if somebody loses, let's say, their hand or limbs or anything of that kind.
Yeah.
Or maybe due to accident or something got amputated or something like that. Yeah. Because of a disease or something.
Yeah.
The first thing we could probably try is a prosthetic, thing. Yeah.
Yeah.
And you can use prosthetics today to have an artificial hand or an artificial limb or anything of that kind.
Yeah, yeah.
And prosthetics has really, you know, helped people who are being disabled to actually, you know, making them more comfortable with having a prosthetics in their with their body.
Yeah, you mean to say the versions and the generations of prosthetics have moved ahead.
Absolutely.
From just being a static prosthetic to being more sensitive to who you are and becoming a part of you more in a more integrated way.
Absolutely.
I remember you telling me that when we were kind of just discussing this over coffee, saying that the static prosthetics move to becoming what did you call the muscular?
Yeah, it's called myoelectric.
Yeah, myoelectric prosthetics.
So myoelectric is basically, I mean, everyone, as you know, even if you get amputated or even if your limbs are cut and any of that kind happens, your muscles still have the capability to pass those signals.
Or the electric signals,
yeah. Except the fact that you don't have that, part which is executing it.
Yeah.
Now, making use of that, prosthetics were developed.
Yeah.
And today prosthetics are really good in a way that, you know, they can use myoelectric things,
yeah,
which are in the muscle. Myo is basically muscle, and electric is the pulse, you know, the electric forces
pulse,
which pass through.
Yeah.
So they use myoelectric mechanisms to ensure that your prosthetics are better fitted to your own, you know, observable motions,
yeah,
which are supported with a battery pack or a, you know, external power source, yeah, because you need an external power source to tell it to execute. So if I want to move my arm, I'll be able to move my arm and things like that. And then it comes already with various settings, which is kind of gets calibration, you know, like the way we calibrate our screen today,
yeah,
for our own, you know, touch based feel.
Yeah.
You when you take a prosthetic, it gets calibrated to your own, you know, myoelectric signals which are there.
Perfect.
Yeah. So that's how it's coming up.
But
and
is that the state of the art now, or is there something next generation on how those prosthetics are also done?
Absolutely. So I don't think it's state of the art today.
Okay.
The reason is, mm-hmm, it's over. We have passed through myoelectric and bionic arms.
Okay.
Now we are in the edge of telling, mm-hmm, prosthetics, mm-hmm, can be controlled by just thinking.
Oh wow.
Which means you can have a brain controlled prosthetics today. Forget your myoelectric, but now it can be brain controlled.
You mean to say something like you capture the signals from the mind and you're able to move your arm or leg or anything?
Absolutely.
Of that sort.
So let's say, you know, I have a prosthetic arm.
Yeah.
I feel I should, you know, lift my hand.
Hmm, hmm.
I just think in the brain that I need to lift my hand.
Yeah.
And that gets lifted.
Lifted. Wow. But this brings a totally different dimension. That means,
yeah,
to say a person who is having a bionic arm not only has hyper flexibility, because you literally can turn your wrist 360,
yeah,
degrees, or
true,
your
true
arm 360,
yeah,
degrees. You can even lift extreme weights because you have the possibility of doing it. But all this can now be done not by you practicing to do it with your arm to try sending certain signals, but directly with a brain interface. Literally, by just thinking about it, you are able to,
yeah,
make it happen.
So
wow,
this is tried in Florida. So there is one man living today,
mm-hmm,
whose arm is brain controlled.
Okay.
He stays in Florida.
Yeah.
And it was with the help of Johns Hopkins, you know, University. They,
mm-hmm,
got it done. So this man is the only man today who is having a prosthetic bionic arm,
wow,
which is mind controlled.
Wow.
And he's trained his, you know, thinking in such a way that now if I want to, I mean, imagine you even can get the finer movements, right?
Yeah.
You know, if I want to lift my
skill to fine motor,
exactly,
skills, yeah.
So if I want to open my little finger, I'll be able to open my little,
yeah,
finger.
But or
just
maybe
by thinking,
put your hand through grains of rice.
Absolutely.
And pick it up. And,
now,
yeah,
this is beautiful, right?
Yeah.
So this is what is making a person with disability,
yeah,
get hyperability.
Absolutely.
Which is beyond our, you know,
your
grade of ability.
My control.
No, right?
You know what? This hyper ability, I'll tell you an interesting story about,
yeah,
this.
Sure.
This story was actually, it came from a very good friend of ours, who is our boss also, Feroz, who's done a lot of work in the disability space.
Absolutely.
We'll leave links to the amount of work he's done. And he's been recognized globally for the work in disability and specifically in autism that he's done. So thanks to him.
Thanks to Feroz.
Even this video is kind of an inspiration from his discussions and talks we have had. But coming back to the topic, something very interesting. Did you know that there is Paralympics, which,
yeah,
means to say people who are disabled participate in their form of Olympics?
Absolutely, yeah.
Did you know the events are also the same, in the sense, you know, 100 meter running is 100 meter running, 1500 meter running is 1500 meter running, swimming is swimming, so on,
okay,
and so forth.
Mm-hmm.
There's no difference in the distances either.
Mm-hmm.
And the only difference is the degree at which somebody is disabled, or the reason at which somebody is disabled,
mm-hmm,
is categorized into one group of people.
Okay.
Now here is an interesting fact.
Okay.
2016 Rio Olympics,
mm-hmm,
something very special happened.
Okay.
1500 meter run,
mm,
normal Olympics happened.
Mm-hmm. Normal meaning normal people running, like
people
you
like you and me.
Yeah, yeah, okay.
Who are not hyperabled.
Mm.
Let's call it that way.
Sure.
Now. The person there, I forget the winner's name.
He's from Algeria, right?
No, he's an American.
Ah, okay.
He clocked 3 minutes 50 seconds. Okay?
Ah, okay.
Now comes the interesting part. 1 month later, Paralympics happens.
Mm-hmm.
And the same 1500 meter run, the first four people who came, the top four,
yeah,
are faster than the person who was the normal person.
So the fellow who won the gold medal at whatever time,
yes, 3:50,
yeah,
was, consider that these five people run together, the disabled people or the hyper-abled people have run faster than the normal human being.
Wow. So which means they have bet their world record,
yes,
of having a gold medal by, absolutely, that normal Olympic guy.
Absolutely.
So,
and the best part of the whole thing is the disabled people were blind.
Oh.
That's even more shocking. First of all, they're disabled, they're blind, and they're running faster than a normal human
amazing
being.
Amazing.
Now, this has led to a different kind of a thought process.
Okay.
I forget the name. I think it's Daniela Bradshaw, okay, in UK. She's a Paralympian.
Uh-huh.
She's about 23 years old. One foot, she has a blade, which means to say it's a prosthetic for,
yeah,
running.
Mm-hmm.
For running, walking,
yeah,
on a day-to-day basis. And one foot is a normal, I mean, one leg is a normal leg,
normal
and
leg,
one leg,
okay,
is a blade leg. Now, she's gone to the authorities and told, I need my normal leg removed.
Oh, she wants it to be, removed.
She wants it to be amputated out, chopped off.
Oh my God.
And she wants to replace that,
okay,
with a blade leg.
Wow, she wants to remove her normal leg normal and leg have a prosthetic instead?
And have a blade leg.
Whoa.
Just because she can run faster, she has hyperability to run faster, to, I don't know, maybe it's more comfortable, I don't know. I'm loss of words to explain what she'll be feeling.
Cool.
Now, this is not just happening only in the space of prosthetic limbs.
Yeah.
People have started thinking, and we'll make it another episode maybe, but I'll just want to drop a point here.
Mm-hmm.
People have been starting to think of cochlear implants, which is basically taking the signals. Deaf people are given a certain small little gadget which, mm-hmm, goes into the ear, which connects directly to the auditory nerve back at the,
correct,
at the mind. There's,
yeah,
there's a chip sitting in the auditory nerve. Now that gives you hyper ability to listen to those frequencies which you normally don't listen to.
Got it.
Right, so it is not a far off day that, sorry to say, you and me, normal people,
we might fall into,
would want a certain disability to happen to be technologically superior, connected into the world, either by having a better prosthetic, like how you said, have a better bionic arm, which is, can lift 600 kilo weight and is turnable 360
absolutely
degrees, or have a different type of a leg because of which you can run faster, walk faster.
Or maybe humans will forcibly put themselves into a hyper-able situation like this because, like you said, if she had the capability to cut her one leg and put in prosthetic,
yeah,
maybe, in the future it could happen, or it will happen for sure. Maybe, we will remove our own, let's say, small little things which we do not want and we feel is not performing enough,
yeah,
and put a new prosthetics on top of it to make it more hyperable, right?
If you really think about it, and we have discussed this always, is the mobile phone is the most powerful gadget that is,
yeah,
there today, and it is an extension of this, essentially. It is an extension of your eye, it's an,
yeah,
extension of your arm, of your ear, everything. Now, imagine if the mobile phone is broken up into different pieces.
Mm.
One is a camera, one is the speakerphone, and so on and so forth.
And it's all there with you. Inside.
And you start implanting those on the auditory nerve, the optic nerve, and everything. The only thing left for you is to be removing your own hands and having a bionic arm, because that's more capable, that's more efficient.
Yeah. I also remember a story. It's a story of a lady called Angel.
Yeah.
And when she was born, she was not, she didn't have an arm.
Mm-hmm.
She was the first one, I guess, to implement a myoelectric arm,
mm-hmm,
when she was a kid, when,
okay,
she was very young.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
From then on, I guess she's around, 25, 30 plus, whatever. Right?
Yeah.
I don't know the exact age of hers, but
yeah.
She is now having a prosthetic arm,
mm-hmm,
which she's advocating it to a lot of people with disability to start using it,
mm-hmm,
and she's been accepted heavily by the normal people today.
Yeah.
Because she's a model,
mm-hmm,
and she's a Hollywood actress.
Wow. Okay.
And she's done in Hunger Games, The Accountant, and multiple, I mean, including Green Lantern.
Oh, you mean to say normal movies, she's able to act with the bionic arm?
Absolutely.
Wow.
And wherever she goes, I think it's a super hit. Because people are like so crazy about that arm of hers, and it looks very beautiful.
Yeah.
And it's so beautiful to see that the disabled person with hyperability is now getting, you know, mingled with the normal society in a normal fashion, and people are agreeing and accepting that.
Yeah.
Right. So that's really awesome. On, you know, how it's changing every single field, like you said, from hearing to running to
vision
to, you know, acting to fashion to, I guess, everything is getting to the way of making it more and more hyperable.
See, I truly believe that, and I think I'd like to put one point here saying that it is not a day far off that we as normal humans will want to be disabled to be hyperable. Because to get to a point of hyperability, you have to lose what you have and you have to start afresh. And it is not going to be a far off day when all of us are going to be hyperabled. Because you can't compete with a person, as we saw in the Paralympic story, you can't compete with a person who is hyperabled.
Yeah.
And normal human beings like you and me don't have infrared vision, or we don't have hypersonic hearing, or whatever we want to call it. And to have those things, we have to be hyperabled. Hence, you have to lose your normal abilities that you have and augment with machine capabilities and hyperabilities.
Slightly scary for me, but yeah, I don't know if that becomes really our future, and if maybe people will, like we discuss, you know, forcibly do it also.
Yep.
And we will see an age of more and more, you know, transhumans.
Yeah.
You know, cyborgs, transhumans in the world where they will be more special. So I don't know, but the good news is people with disability today can be hyperable, and they really don't have to worry about disability anymore.
Yeah.
For any kind of disability.
Absolutely.
Which is amazing to see.
Yeah. So do leave your thoughts and comments and more on this. As to saying what you think about disability turning to hyperability and normal humans wanting disability to become hyperable.
Yeah.
And I know it's a little bit of a kind of a strange topic, but we want your participation and your thoughts on this. And probably till then, till next week, when we come out with our next topics, do let us know. Do let your topics keep coming in so that we can research and we can talk more about it. Till then,
bye bye.
Bye bye.